absolutely fabulous. This part is a little nerve-wracking, all right? Because this is the time they have to come on and ask the question. You know, forward. Yeah, there we go. And they're going to pull a question out, and I'm going to have to ask that question. Now, you know, guys, this is the part right here where it gets a little tricky for me. So I want you to be as encouraging as possible, but also be quiet so that they can actually answer your question. And once they answer, what do you do? Give them a round of applause. How you doing, Matilda? You good? Well, I don't know how to get you in. You can take that. You're looking really lovely, girl. I could borrow that dress. Can I borrow your dress? What if somebody said I can't fit in that dress? You think I can fit in this dress too? You know what I'm saying? I mean, you look amazing. How do you feel about tonight so far?
It's going good.
It's going good?
Yeah.
Now the thing is, I don't think you're supposed to have been able to see that. So I
got
you're not looking.
Not looking.
Judge, she didn't look.
I wasn't looking.
I promise you, she wasn't looking. But you're feeling good about tonight.
Yep.
What made you enter this pageant? You just like it.
I definitely wanted to try it since my sister went here.
Yeah.
And it was always like, I want to try to be Miss Cedar Bridge.
Yeah.
So it was just a game, just to try.
So I got to ask you this question. Are you ready?
Yeah. Okay. Well, go ahead.
We've never been for that, right? All right. If you had to be someone else for a day, who would that person be and why?
That's a good question. As stereotypical to myself, I would choose my mom because she's such a strong and powerful woman. She works so hard to provide for me and my siblings, and I want to see how it is in her life, you know, working up and all of that. It seems cool and stressful, and I want to be able to be in her shoes to know what she goes through so I can appreciate her even more than I do now.
Next contestant, please. Okay, next contestant. here. There we go. This makes it easier. What is the greatest challenge facing teenagers today?
I feel that the greatest challenge facing teenagers today is that we are very judgmental and we like to compare ourselves to people, especially those on the internet who seem like they're living a good life, but in actual fact it's not really a good life. We tend to make ourselves feel like we have to be in that position, or that's what success looks like, so we have to go through the same route that they do. I do feel that we are very judgmental. We like to judge people based on how they act and what they do, and we also like to fit in with other people just because we think that it's cool or that that's how it's supposed to be.
If there was one country that you could visit, where would it be and why?
One country that I would visit would be Africa. Why? Because in Africa there are many different social classes. North Africa, South Africa, it's like the different, I would say, regions of Africa. It's, you would see poverty or people who have quite a bit of money, and it'll be good to see both sides, even though it's the same country. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Next contestant. Where did you get your dress from? Ooh, I like that side too. My sense, what made you? What is your biggest weakness, and how can you turn it into a strength?
My biggest weakness is that I'm not as confident as anybody, like a lot of people, and I have really big anxiety, but I can turn it into a strength in working through it and practicing and participating in events like this.
Touches,
I'm here. So how are you feeling about tonight?
I'm feeling good.
rejects the gender.
Start a recycling club. We can start
All right, now we're moving on to our next contestant.
Nothing.
actual question. What do you think is Bermuda's greatest asset? Explain your response.
I believe Bermuda's greatest asset is the tourism industry. I think that because that is one of the main, I want to say, factors of bringing in money. So without tourism, we wouldn't have the amount of money we have in Bermuda, so things wouldn't be built as fast as they would because we bring in materials, which require money. Thank you.
have four guys, so all of the four gentlemen will be going on to the finals. All of the four gentlemen, and we have to pick four ladies. So that's what I'm waiting on. I'm just waiting for the actual finalists, and then we can proceed with moving on with the program. So judges, I gotta ask you, walk down like a lady real quick. Now obviously you can't show bias, and he's looking at me like, don't come next to him, so I'm gonna come right at you. How you feeling about this program?
I think this is an excellent program. It gives the students opportunity to showcase the talents that they might not necessarily thought they had. So a lot of them have seen errors, but they've gotten through it, so hopefully they can take this experience and move on to the next phase of life, and we'll do them much better, put them in a better sphere.
What advice would you give? Thank you so much, that was a great answer. You know, sometimes when people are afraid to talk on a mic, you kind of wonder what they're going to say, but you did amazing. You're not scared, okay. Tanika, what advice would you have for these young people?
I think what I would say to them is what I say to most of my students is keep pushing forward. And I'm so proud of those who are conquering their fears and their nerves and they push through. And I continue to diversify their portfolios and try as many different things as possible. And succeed in as many different things as possible. The sky's the limit. And don't let anybody put them in a box because they are pretty amazing young people.
I'm just going to check really quickly, do we have the finalist names yet? Not yet, okay. I'm just making sure, so guys, because I know the audience sometimes looks at like, why does she keep talking? A lot of times when a host is talking, it's just to make sure that we can let the judges and everybody do what they have to do. So, what was your feeling about tonight?
You're exactly right in saying that we have a hard decision to make, because each and every one of the students
job.
Their talents are amazing, their answers are amazing,
they're
just all students' excellence.
Now I know, Troika, when you were looking at some of these young people, didn't you see that talent up on that stage? And how did you feel witnessing that? Because some of these young people probably haven't performed before.
First of all, I definitely think that everyone who stepped on stage this evening is a winner. Getting up on stage is definitely not easy. The talent in this room is phenomenal, and I would encourage each of them to continue to strive for excellence in whatever they do. And I would encourage the community that is here tonight to continue to push these young people because they are our future, and it's important that they get that support.
And I know that you didn't want this. So just some final thoughts. What are your final thoughts on this? Because I know that we should have the tally by now.
Romina has a lot of rich talent, and I think it's all been shown here tonight. And congratulations to the parents who are behind these amazing students that are on stage this evening. Romina has a great future ahead of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And I'm going to run back up here. And I didn't fall. All right, so I think we have the finalists. Thank you. Much appreciated, guys. Just waiting for the sheet. Do we have it? Okay, no problem. I'm sorry about that, guys. Got a mixed message there. But I'm still gonna walk around and talk to the rest and see who else people are represented. How you doing? You okay? Who you representing? You don't wanna talk about it.
Yellow lesbian.
Michaela, okay. And what about you?
Smiling at me.
And think about how pretty you're gonna dress. Can someone give me the signal when everybody is in the soundproof booth, please?
What you're saying.
to our next contestant. There we go, Lori.
For all people to provide with more ways.
And all of our judges will need to deliberate. I want you to give all of our contestants a round of applause.
Rest of my studies, but I would love to be a social worker.
much, darling. Coming up next, we have former CBA student, DeBray Evans, who will be invited to perform at a dance. Put your hands together. Okay, before she performs, we're going to have words from Maya Smith, who was Mr. Cedar Bridge 2000.
Happy family, my name is Miles Smith, your current reigning Mrs. Cedar Bridge Academy. So being that I am Mrs. Cedar Bridge Academy, it is my job to not only tell you where I am currently and what I'm doing, but also to wish the participants luck. So first of all, I'm going to tell you where I am. I'm currently in Potenza, Italy, with my Upper People cast. And basically, if you don't know what Upper People is, it's a nonprofit organization that grabs 100 people from around the world, and we perform, travel, stay close family, and do community service. So being in the class of 2020 knows that I am extra in any way I can. I decided that I'm not going to wish them luck by myself. I'm going to use my cats. So.
Said I shake my hand and I roll my dice. Got a double the price in the box this night. I come for the lights, I ain't come for the hype. But if I'm going straight through, fresh stepping out and on it. Let's remember the channel all with them on it. Breath back. Said who gon' see it, who gon' say it, who gon' want it up. Said who gon' turn around, catch in the moment.
I'm gonna go.
and a million men for a full menage. Every upstore chili in the city yard. So you can't win the game if you don't play a card. I can play ball. I can be big with drums. Say I'm the Lord.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I know it's pretty late and you're a bit tired, but I just want you to give our contestants another round of applause, please.
Can you just come forward?
I just want to say thank you to all of the other Evercore students. To our visiting ladies and technician, led by Tess Faye and Marcus, thank you to our backstage crew, led by Kelly Robinson, another Evercore student, and Mrs. Cho Wolf. Thank you, and of course, our patrons, our sponsors. We have those mentioned already to our valued patrons. We truly appreciate you. I think we leave tonight, we have 57 patrons. So thank you for everyone who purchased tickets, who are here to support our class of 2020. Just know that we truly thank you. And I see the judges are here, so therefore we do have our results. And again, thanks everyone for being here.
Let's give our contestants another round of applause. All of them. I want you to court every single one of you. Tonight what I saw on the stage was absolutely amazing. Each and every single one of you did an amazing job. I know some of you are probably like, oh, everything. No, honestly, you guys got up on the stage, that's the first step. And being in a place like Bermuda, where people are, you know, small, right? Sometimes it's really, really hard. So I just want to applaud each and every one of you. You did an amazing job. You look amazing. And gentlemen, you looking this way? Listen, this is the first time that I've been on stage and each of you had me speechless. I'm really serious. You guys did an amazing job. Big up yourself, okay? Big up yourself. Yes. I'm gonna be checking up on you. All right?
Big up yourself.
All right, I'm gonna get ready to make some announcements.
Ready.
This is the time that everybody's been waiting for, right? Congeniality, if we can get a picture of congeniality first. Could you be up in front so we can get the pictures taken? Okay, we're going to ask you if you can move to the side here, guys. Take a step to your left.
Yes.
I'm moving to the left so you can get the picture. And photogenic, and you can also come over afterwards as well, as soon as they take their picture. You ready? I don't want to flash. We're going to give out the certificates of participation to each individual that participated.
Yes, CBA!
at this time. I'm going to need a drum roll, please. Mr. Cedarbridge 2020 is... They will take their final walk.